So, namaskar. Main hu Sapna Khadelwal and I welcome you to this session of Devdithi Foundation ki Personal Transformation Series. Devdithi Foundation ek aisi sanstha hai which empowers women to empower themselves by way of many and numerous educative and entertaining programs which are held both online and offline. Devdithi Transformation कि इस सीरीज के तहत बहुत सारे गेस्ट स्पीकर्स आते हैं और अपनी वैल्यू ऐड करते हैं मेंबर्स और गेस्ट की लाइफ्स को ट्रांसफॉर्म करने के लिए. देवदीदी फाउंडेशन इसके अलावा ह्यूमैनिटेरियन बैंक का काम करता है, जहां जरूरत होती है वहां पे चीजों को पहुंचाता है इन टर्म्स ऑफ मटीरियल एड और इन टर्म्स ऑफ फिजिकल एड. जैसे भी हो, हम उस तरीके की कोशिश करते हैं टू आइडेंटिफाई द नीड्स ऑफ द टारगेट ग्रुप्स एंड वी गैदर ऑल आवर मेंबर्स एंड विद देयर सपोर्ट हम वहां पे हेल्प प्रोवाइड करते हैं. तो आइए अब हम चलते हैं आज के गेस्ट स्पीकर कौन है उनके बारे में बता के और उनको हम इनवाइट करते हैं. सो टुडे वी हैव अ वेरी टैलेंटेड लेडी. We have Malvika Sehgal Kaura with us, and this is the second session that she's doing for Devdithi Foundation, and she's a very versatile lady. And not only does she do styling and clothes, but art mein bhi inka bahut naam hai. Aur ab ye classes lene lagi hain, online classes. So today she's going to teach us how to paint the Devi with Malvika Sehgal Kaura. So without further ado, I welcome Malvika and I ask her, request her to talk a little bit about herself and then begin the session. Thank you. Over to you, Malvika.
Thank you so much, Sapna. That was a lovely introduction. It's a pleasure always to be associated with Devdithi and all the amazing work you lovely ladies do. It's a pleasure. It's all mine. And I am an artist who paints Vastu and Feng Shui paintings. My paintings heal and manifest. Yes, it is possible through painting. I'm also an art therapist. So I take therapy sessions of people with psychological problems, heart issues, cancer. I am consulting with a lot of NGOs and other, you know, holistic healing modules where we teach art therapy. I'm based in South Delhi. I have an art and fashion studio which displays artworks, and my art classes before the pandemic were held there. Now I teach art online, personal and group classes. Today's session is Devi painting for the simple reason that the festive season is coming. So you'd like to make a painting. This is a painting you could gift for Karwa Chauth, or otherwise you could use this painting in your home to make it more Shaktiman and to bring in a lot of Vastu energy for the festive season. My art classes are very, very affordable. So people now in the festive season like to take a lot of art classes, because even if you're gifting someone something, it's nice. If you could make a card with it or a painting with it, it's a fabulous idea for Karwa Chauth and the festivities to follow. Upgrade your shoes, your bags, all that with art that you can put your own art on your things with a session with me. Now, today's class is, I've asked you guys to get a 10 by 12 canvas. However, mine is a little bigger and I have a square canvas, which I'm using today because I had this lying with me. I've unfortunately used up all the other canvases I had. So I'm going to reverse the camera where you will be able to see the canvas and the brushwork. Now, let me just tell you what all I've done with this. The canvas, like I'd sent you the image, the sketch of the Devi, whatever you want to make. It's a very simple sketch with a flowing line. Then I outline the painting because I'm doing it on canvas. I'm not doing it on paper. So what happens is when you use typically a lot of paint, your pencil marks get covered. So I've done a black outline with acrylic paint with a thin brush. You can use a two number, never use a one number for an outline because it just isn't steady enough. After the outline dried, I wet my canvas. Yes, this is a trick I teach all my students and in my classes. What happens is when your canvas is wet, the paint will spread super easy. You will absorb lesser paint and it will not be patchy. So it works on a lot of fronts. If you're lazy, just take your canvas, stick it in the tub, but make sure your outline is totally dry before you do that. Once it is wet, and I do it with a brush because I like the canvas, because canvas is basically a cloth, to absorb the water, I have taken this color, which is a fluorescent orange. It's an acrylic paint. These are more liquid than the tube paints and they just spread easy. They're great for a background. They're not really good for detailing. So I decided to use this color. Now I'm going to flip the paint and 1 second. Okay. So this is the color I'm talking about. This is the thick brush. And this is how much of the painting I have done. The rest of it I'm going to do in front of you. I'm sorry, I had to do a little bit because of the time constraint. So you have the background, the outline. This is the nut. This is my adaptation of a Devi, of course. You could make it different. You could make the eyes open. You could make eyelashes. You could make thicker eyebrows. That's your interpretation. So before we start, can we all just close our eyes for a second and put the intent out there? What do you want to intend with this painting? I'll give you an example. If I'm having a problem sleeping, I will just pray to the painting that I'm going to put all my energies here. Please help me sleep well tonight. It could be anything. It could be that you want to be in a happier frame of mind. Protection of the Devi, so you want divine protection. Close your eyes and let's put the intent out there. Great. I hope you have your wish that you remember. We are going to start work on this. So there are three colors I'm using only in this painting today because I wanted to keep it simple. One is a fluorescent yellow. One is a black for the highlights. And one is this orange that I showed to you earlier. I'm going to now take a smaller brush, which is number, you'll have to excuse how dirty my brushes are, but they just do a lot of painting work. This is a number 4. So you could use a number 2 or whatever. You keep your brush wet. Always keep, before working on your brushes, make sure you dip them in water and they're nice and wet. So this is...
Excuse me.
Yes.
Please, can you repeat your colors?
I've used a fluorescent orange, a fluorescent yellow and black, but you can use whatever color you have. Or you wish you could have the whole Devi in shades of blue and your highlight could be a white. You could do it. It depends on what your interpretation of the painting is. So if you can see, I am putting the brush along the crease of the eye and I'm making sure that I've, I'm pressing it in such a way that you have a little depth towards the eyelid and it's a little lighter on the top. Now, the reason I do that is so that it's a natural crease without really needing to give too much of detailing so that it's quicker. I now rinse my brush a bit because I want to show you one eye. This is the fluorescent yellow. I'm using this in place of white. I just thought it would be interesting. And this is, you know, the shine that you give on an eyelid, like what you do with an eyeshadow, this is what I'm doing. When you do a face painting, it's a lot like doing nice makeup because since this is a Devi painting, you will want that you give, make her look as beautiful as you envision her to be. So if you see naturally, this eye has already got a 3D effect. It's as simple as that. And your eye is done. So I'm going to do the same to the other eye. And this is it. Probably add a little more orange on the tip of the second eye. And my eyes are ready. Yeah, it's that simple. Once your background is done and your outline is done, this is how it's looking already. Now, the thing is that the face, I wanted to give a little contouring. So I'm going to take, this is the black I'm using. It's an acrylic black. I always buy the bigger tubes apart from my sets. I have the full sets and the tubes because I use a lot of paint. So I'm just going to take a little out on my canvas. And I have already got, this is a number two brush. Like I told you, I prefer working with a two than a zero or a one because it has a better grip. Again, you wet your brush, you make sure it soaks in the water. You take a little bit of your black and you start with a very firm hand on your eyebrows. So in this class, because it is there is a time constraint, that's the eyebrow. I will be only talking in monologue and taking your questions in the end. But when you take my personal classes, in that I show a bit, then I wait for you to do a bit, and then, you know, I get on to the next step. So that's more personal. This you can save. All their videos are available on YouTube, the Dev Diti videos. So you can see this later and you can always pause it and work alongside. So that is my outline. Normally, one would outline towards the end of the painting. The reason I'm outlining this before is I want the outline to dry and I want to do a texture so that I can show you a little bit about knife painting. This is an acrylic paint knife. You can use this for oil also, but never mix your tools. Your acrylic paint tools are separate and your oil paint tools always have to be separate. So I wanted to do a little knife work. So I want this to dry up. Hence, I'm doing the outline here. I can't outline the eyes because they're still wet. If I outline them, then they will just bleed. And I'm going to also outline the bindi. The bindi is up to you. You can wear a lovely round bindi, or you can make an oval bindi, or you can make a designed bindi. You can make a trishul on her forehead. However you perceive the Devi. I mean, it depends on what you want to draw. These are the nostrils. And I'm just, this is my nut. So these are the golden beads on the nut. I'm going to just do this slightly because one outline has already been done. And then with the yellow, I will highlight it in the end so that the nut shines out. And that's that. And these are my lips. Now, if you see on the lips, I am going to just press down my brush on the lower lip because the lower lip is normally always darker than the upper lip. So you want, and I've given a little cleft because I think that looks very nice on a lip. And I'm taking just a little water in the brush with the black, and I'm just kind of giving it a little bit of texture. So her lips are a little darker than the rest. And the color will come on top of this. So this base is done. And now we just do the texture of the back of the painting. So see, you can already see the Devi painting coming out. So the way to use a knife is you take your paint, you have the, this is the back of my knife. So I take the paint in this, like this, that's it, in the back. And you try and the surface that you're going to, you press it down towards the tip. And this is how it comes. It doesn't come very even. It's not supposed to be. The minute I'm putting a knife on a painting, the reason is because I want some texture on my painting. It is not to create an even surface because the even surface can be created only with a brush. So this is because I want the bindi and everything else to just stand out a little bit. So I'm going to do it with knife. I'm going to let it dry. And then I'll do a coat over it. And if Devditi wants, then I can finish the painting in a day or two and show you guys the finished painting that I'll check with them and get back to you about. So since this is the eyebrow and it is kind of dry in places, this is what I'm just going to do, a little bit of knife work around. So the eye looks a little raised, and the same this side. So what it does in the end, you'll see it'll create a lot of depth. Now I'm coming to the eye because I'd like to create some drama here. So I'm going to, it's still wet because there was a lot of water in the eyelid. So I'm just creating a little bit of depth on the sides, on the crease of the eye. Like I said, it's a lot like you're doing makeup. And I think that's probably why I've always enjoyed doing makeup, because the artistic part of me always enjoys this. So I'm getting this now to the lips. I'm going to try and get there. I've just dropped a blob of paint there, here. So I'm getting this to the lip with my knife. I'm trying to create the depth here so you take, the paint has to be taken at the back of the knife. And this is, and I'm just going to circle the lower lip so that there's a little bit of structure. That is it. That is as far as the knife goes in this. So whatever's left, I'll just kind of put it on the back. If you can see, this is adding a little bit of texture. Yeah? Also, because of the time that we have, this is a very simple painting. There are a lot of complicated paintings one could do where, you know, there's time invested in sketching. But for now, this should do, just to start with. So this is my brush now. This is a thick brush. This is number 12. If you're using a 10 by 12 canvas, then you can use a number 8. You don't need such a big brush. So this is my background, and I'm just going to carefully take it outside the eye so that the part which is wet, I don't want that to bleed. I want that to dry. And the nose, the outline is still not dry. So this is up to you. You want to create, make it patchy, you can put your strokes like this. You can put your strokes like this. What I do when I want an even surface is first do my strokes vertically and then horizontally. It's up to you how you want to do it. Because since this is just an abstract painting, there's nothing definitive about it. That's the beauty of abstract art. It's very forgiving. Even if you make a mistake, it will look like it's part of the painting. I'm just gonna turn this. So this is your background. Now we come to the bindi, which is here. So you take your brush, you've already created a little dent here with the knife painting, and you're merging all of it. And it's ready, but I've try to make sure that I don't merge this. Now, once this whole thing dries, which should take about 15, 20 minutes or more, then I will be making a full wash of paint over this, leaving the nut. So when I say a wash is, I take thick paint, I add a little water dilute and make it consistent. And then this is done. Now, until then, I'll show you something else that I do with my spiritual paintings, because that's mainly what I do. So every time I start a painting or a canvas, I mark it. Like in my case, I follow Guruji. So it's Jai Guruji and there's an Om. You can put whatever you want. I'm just going to take you through closer to the depth of the eye here. This is the crease. This is the bindi. And this is the lip. Now, this is not going to end up looking like this because then the wash of the paint will come over the entire baby, the canvas. But if you can see, it is looking like this already.
Malvika, can I interrupt?
Of course.
So there's a question. Did you color the entire canvas base orange before starting?
Yes, I did. I did actually. We can take a few questions now because I have to wait for 5-7 minutes for this to dry. So yes, I did paint the... So I washed the entire canvas with water and this thick brush number 12 that I was painting with. You can take... See, to wash the canvas, you can take any brush. This is the one I washed my canvases with. This
so what do you mean by washing the canvas? Like you painted the entire canvas and then dipped it in the water?
No. I'll explain it again. So when you buy a canvas from the market,
your volume is too low. Can you increase your volume?
You check if this is okay, otherwise I'll get my headphones.
Earlier it was fine. Suddenly it's gone low.
I'll try. Let's see if this works. Then okay. let me know. So when you pick up a canvas from the market, there is a lot of treatment that's put on it. Preservatives are put on it so that the canvas doesn't get spoiled. It doesn't rot because typically, canvases can get spoiled with like paper. There's all kind of things that happen to it. So the reason I wash and prep the base of my canvas is because it does two things. It makes it very easy for you to make the background. Now, I am an artist who always works background first. There are lots of artists who first paint their painting and then do the background. I don't believe in doing that because what happens is once you finish your painting and you start doing the background, there is always some brushwork or some paint you're going to get onto your main picture. Then you're going to work again in fixing your picture. So what I do is I always do my background. Hence, because I do a background, I need to outline my image so it doesn't merge with the paints in the background. Is my voice okay now? Would you like me to get my headphones? Is the voice okay?
Anybody having problem? I can hear. It's
absolutely
slow.
Okay. Absolutely okay.
Fine.
Excellent. Thank you so much. Thank you. So that is why I like to. And the other thing is, the things like chemicals on your canvas. There might be some dust on your canvas. When you wash your canvas, it is. And I wash it just with plain water. I don't put soap on it. I just wash it with water. You can stick it under the tap if you want, or you can use a brush like I was telling you about, like a thick brush. To the difference of washing it with a brush is that I keep doing it over and then I look at it in the light and see there might be some points of the canvas where there is, they put a layer of some chemical so the water is not going in. The idea is for the canvas to soak in the water. That really works. After which I have taken my orange color. I am just going to tell you the number. It's a neon orange. It is Fevicryl. Yes, I do Akanksha. No. That would be wrong. I sketch my painting. Your painting sketch is the first thing you're going to do. First, you sketch what you want to draw. Then you outline it with any color you want, which is going to show. So I outlined it with black. Let me see the brush. This is the number 2. There's someone who wants to see the painting. Okay, let me just show you standing. Yeah, it's already looking like this. Yeah, and it still needs a lot. There's a lot that still has to go into it.
Thank you.
So you outline the painting. Then once you outline the painting and the outline has dried, that's very important because my nose, the outline I did in front of you because I put paint on it and it hadn't dried fully, it bled. So outline your painting, let it dry, typically 20-30 minutes, after which you wash your canvas. The canvas is washed after that, not before. So wait for 30 minutes. If you made a thick outline, you might even have to wait for an hour. Like I made this in the afternoon and then I send the image to them to send it to you so that you could start drawing it. So mine was resting for 2-3 hours. And sometimes because I make so many artworks, there will be a day where I'm doing all my sketching and all my outlining and the next day I will do the washing and the background. So you could do that too. You could wait for a day. So then I did, so you sketch, you outline, you wash the canvas, you do your background, and then you start your detailing. So does that answer you, Akanksha? Is that good? Sounds good. Okay, great. Super. So now that this has kind of dried, I'm going to take the camera back to the painting. Just give me a second. Yeah. Okay. So we had So now I'm going to be using a smaller brush, which is number 4, number 6, whatever. I'm taking my orange paint. My canvas is already quite damp. If you still want more water, you can add water to the paint. Please never put paint on your brush, then put it in the water because you're wasting that paint. It's going to go in the water. So always, always dip your brushes in paint. And I want to tell you another thing, which I'll show you. In acrylic paint, you have a pot of water, and please excuse how messy it is. And my brush, my scalpel, everything lies in the water once I use it. So do not leave your paint brushes dry, your scalpel dry, because it will spoil your brushes. And once you finish your artwork, every day, even if you're painting for 1 hour and you think, maybe I'll get time to paint in the evening, please wash your brushes with soapy water. I've actually kept chemical-free soap for my paint brushes. And I wash, like if I'm even painting morning and evening, I'm washing my brushes with soap. It takes 5 minutes. You have to wet your brushes. You put the soap on, leave it on for about 30 seconds and rinse off your brushes. I think someone needs to mute their...
Yeah. There's another question that how did you paint your background?
I just took my canvas was... Can you mute her, please?
I just see who is unmuted. I don't know.
I'll have a look.
How did I paint the background? Your canvas is already wet. It is soaking wet. And then I took this orange color with my big brush.
Just a minute, Malvika. People are speaking a bit. So I'm trying to mute the person.
I muted.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you. Muted.
Okay. You can carry on now. You can tell the base. How did you do it?
Thank you. So your canvas is soaking wet. I took this big fat brush, number 12, which was already wet. The brush also has to be wet. It has to be soaked. It has to soak in the water. And then I took a little water and I just did horizontal and diagonal strokes. And that's it. And because it's already soaking wet, the paint spreads.
Okay.
that is your background for you. And of course, that is patchy. So you work on the background on top of that. So now what I'm doing is, since the knife painting has dried, there is some amount of texture that the knife painting has provided to my painting. There's the eyelids are looking absolutely gorgeous. They're standing out. So now I am just taking this orange color. Now the difference in a tube paint and these paints, I must tell you, is these paints are far more liquid. This would be better. See, they're far more liquid. The tube paints are a little drier. So like in this right now, I don't need to add water. But if I was taking out paint from a tube, suppose I'm using one of these tubes, then I have to add water. Then I can't paint straight unless it's a really dry painting and I'm doing a lot of detailing. But that has to be another class where I'll tell you where you can paint straight from the... So this is... My texture is already coming out. There's a certain sheen which is coming out in to the painting. I don't mind if I get some paint onto the black. I didn't want too much of stark black anyway. And this is, I'm doing the nose now. And I'm soon going to get onto my nose pin because I want to show that to you. You know, there's a way to make sure that you get a lot of depth. Just with a single color or two colors, you can get a 3D effect. So I'm painting around the nose pin and I want it to dry so that I can use it next. Yeah. And if you, I'm going to just show you the lips now. The 3D effect was there. It's still a little wet, but I'm going to just take a little paint on my brush and I'm going to go over the lip. So I've got some texture on her mouth, yet it's not looking like it's uneven. Yeah. And it's a little arty, you know, it's not just plain, which is, please make sure that you don't get any, you know, like sometimes the paint curdles and when it's lying here. So please make sure that you clean out your brush of any, you know, little lumps you get of paint. That looks very bad in the painting because when you finally remove it, it looks, it leaves a gap. And if you do not remove it, it is raised. So it looks a little odd.
Malvika, so can we have yes? more of Hindi? Can we have more of Hindi, please? Thoda sa Hindi ko log message kar rahe hain alag se.
So you're going Achha, to
thoda sa Hindi mein bhi aur bol lo. Thank you.
Thank you. So, ye jaise, पेंट कर्डल हो जाता है इकट्ठा हो जाता है तो ये कैनवस पे आ जाते हैं ये बहुत बुरे लगते हैं बिकॉज जब ये ड्राई हो जाते हैं तो ये लंपी हो जाते हैं कैनवस में और अगर उस टाइम आप हटाओगे तो वो कैनवस नीचे प्लेन होगा तो ये ध्यान रखिए कि कोई लंप्स ना हो आपके कैनवस पे उसको साथ साथ सूखे कपड़े से हटाते रहिए अब हम उनकी देवी की नथ करेंगे जो येलो फ्लोरेसेंट येलो मैंने यहाँ पे लिया हुआ है आप गोल्डन येलो ले सकते हैं व्हाइट ले सकते हैं इसमें ऐड कर सकते हैं ये मैंने इसमें पानी नहीं डाला बिकॉज मैं नहीं क्योंकि कैनवस गीला है नथ के आसपास गीला है तो मैं नहीं चाहती ये और गीला हो सो आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू फोकस माई हैंड एंड जस्ट पुट अ डॉट जो दो नंबर का ब्रश होता है उससे डॉट बनाना बहुत आसान हो जाता है क्योंकि उसको सिर्फ आपको प्रेस डाउन करना है ये ऐसे ये 3D इफेक्ट आ रहा है नथ में मैं बाद में आपको क्लोजअप में दिखा दूंगी सो दिस इज योर नथ कमिंग आउट एंड इट्स एक्चुअली स्टैंडिंग आउट लाइक इट्स कार्व्ड ये ऐसे लग रहा है जैसे ये अभी कार्व हुआ हुआ है ऐसे खड़ा हो रहा है सो वो ऑफ कोर्स जब वो ड्राई होगा वो थोड़ा सेटल हो जाएगा पर उसका जो लुक है वो नहीं जाएगा वो ऐसे ही रहेगा और ब्राइट रहेगा ऐसे और क्योंकि आउटलाइन पहले हुआ था तो वो आउटलाइन अब शैडो का काम कर रही है वो लग रहा है जैसे उसमें मैंने शैडो क्रिएट किया है तो ये एडवांटेज है आउटलाइन पहले करने का कि वो शैडो का काम कर देती है और वो थोड़ा सा रेज्ड लुक देता है मैं आपको ये निकाल के दिखाती हूँ ये देखिए ये आप देख रहे हैं, ये थोड़ा सा रेज्ड पूरा लग रहा है नथ। सो ये वाला लुक है आपकी देवी का पेंटिंग का। इसमें थोड़ा सा स्मज हो गया था जो मैं बाद में ठीक करूंगी। अब इसमें मैं आपको एक चीज दिखाऊंगी, थोड़ा सा अगर आपको लिप में हाइलाइट्स देनी हो तो ये मेरा येलो कलर है, क्योंकि आज मैंने डिसाइड किया था कि मैं सिर्फ दो रंग से पेंटिंग बनाऊंगी और इसमें मैंने थोड़ा सा ऑरेंज मिक्स किया है। प्लेन मत यूज कीजिए, हमेशा मिक्स करके यूज कीजिए, नहीं तो वो नेचुरल नहीं लगता। ये आपका अपलिप है तो इसमें मैं थोड़ा सा कलर ये वाला यूज कर रही हूं, जिससे आपको थोड़ा सा हाईलाइट यहाँ पे आ गया है। और ये टू जस्ट मेक द लोअर लुक अ लिटिल मोर सेंसुअस, दिस इज सो इट्स शाइनिंग, दिस इज हाउ इट्स लुकिंग राइट नाउ। अब इसमें पूरा जब ये नथ सूख जाएगी ये पूरा फिर बैकग्राउंड बनेगा, और ये जब डार्क होगा तो ये फेस स्टैंड आउट होगा। अब इसमें मल्टीपल फिनिशेस हैं जो हम कर सकते हैं, बट वो मैं इस क्लास में, बिकॉज सपना वी नीड टू डू क्यू एन ए नाउ, और डू आई हैव मोर टाइम टू शो टेक्सचर?
हैव टाइम अभी, यू कैन टेक।
अच्छा, आई कैन टेक, ओके ओके।
सो क्यू एन ए साथ में कर भी रहे हैं तो आई थिंक यू हैव टाइम मल्विका।
अच्छा ठीक है,
एंड पीपल आर पुटिंग क्वेश्चंस साइड बाय साइड, सो इट्स ओके।
अगर आप पूछ रहे हो ना,
हां नहीं, आई एम सेइंग पीपल आर पुटिंग क्वेश्चंस साइड बाय साइड सो वी कैन कैरी ऑन, we don't need time for
questions. Whenever you ask her questions, padke aap pooch lo inko na shuru se.
There's no question at the moment. We have already taken the questions.
Okay, okay. Kisi ka reh na jaye na, fir people.
Ha, no, I'm taking in between.
All right, okay.
So I'm now doing the background, leaving a little bit of the lip so that wo smudge na ho. So थोड़ा सा लिप को छोड़ के मैं बैकग्राउंड कर रही हूँ। आप देख सकते हैं कि मेरे ब्रश में ऑलरेडी काफी पानी है, बिकॉज़ वो ब्रश सोक था, और ये मेरा बैकग्राउंड है पेंटिंग का, जिसको मैं आपको थोड़ा सा दिखा देती हूँ कि इसमें अब ये मैं कर रही हूँ। आप प्लीज पैलेट में अपना कलर निकाल लेना, पर क्योंकि टाइम कम है मैं सीधा निकाल रही हूँ। ये आपका बैकग्राउंड का, ये डायरेक्ट पेंट है। अगेन मैं आपको फिर रिमाइंड कर रही हूँ, वो जो बॉटल वाले पेंट्स होते हैं, वो ये बॉटल वाले आते हैं कोई 90 रुपीस का, इतना बड़ा आता है, ये मैं बैकग्राउंड के लिए यूज करती हूँ। तो ये थोड़े लिक्विड आते हैं, ट्यूब वाले थोड़े ड्राई होते हैं, उनमें पानी डालिए। सो अगर आप बैकग्राउंड आप देख रहे हैं, इसमें ये ऐसे लग रहा है, ये द finish is like this. So you can in this when it's a little drier you can make brush sirf strokes, ya agar jaise maine isme thoda sa yellow dena hai. Preeti, it's fevicryl, I think this one is fevicryl, but camel is good, fevicryl is good, these big bottles I think you only get in fevicryl. So ye aapka आप अगर आप कोई और थोड़ा कलर थोड़ा डेप्थ बैकग्राउंड में भी देना हो, तो जैसे ये येलो मैंने ऐड कर दिया है, इससे मेरा एक टेक्सचर बनना शुरू हो गया है। सो एक ये है, दूसरा टेक्निक है कि जैसे आपने येलो लिया और आपको सर्कुलर पैटर्न बनाना है, अपना ब्रश लीजिए, उसको घुमाइए, उसका ऑफ कोर्स साइड्स को कवर करके, बट यू कैन मेक अ बैकग्राउंड इन सर्कल्स। सो दिस इज द लुक ऑफ क्लाउड्स। सो वन इज दिस द क्लाउडी लुक, एंड वन इज लाइक दिस विच इज अ सॉलिड रेड डार्क लुक। अब वो आपकी चॉइस है कि आपको किस टाइप में बनाना है। ये वाला टेक्निक आपको पसंद है कि दूसरा? You can also try and mix the two. दोनों को mix भी कर सकती हैं, क्योंकि ये abstract art में यही तो फायदा है कि आप कोई भी चीज बनाओ वो अच्छी लगती है। एज लॉन्ग एज वो इवेंचुअली ब्लेंड कर रही है और स्टैंड आउट नहीं कर रही. मेरा फोकल पॉइंट इस पूरी पेंटिंग में देवी का फेस, उनकी बिंदी, उनकी नथ, उनका उनके फीचर्स हैं. ये मैं बाद में ठीक करूंगी बिकॉज इसमें मेरे को थोड़ा सा पेंट में व्हाइट मिला के इसको ठीक करना पड़ेगा. दैट्स वाई आउटलाइन को ड्राई कराना बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. आउटलाइन अगर ड्राई नहीं होगी तो आपके कलर्स ब्लेंड करेंगे. दीज पेंट्स कैन ऑल्सो बी यूज व्हेन आई वाज टॉकिंग टू यू अबाउट क्लासेस दैट आई टेक टू डू अप योर क्लोथ्स, यू नो, दुपट्टा, साड़ी और इवन योर बैग्स, इवन योर सैंडल्स. इफ यू हैव कैनवस सैंडल्स और शूज, वी पेंट ओवर दोज. तो ये वाले जो पेंट्स हैं ये कपड़ों पे, दुपट्टों पे, जूतों पे, बैग्स पे, सब पे लग सकते हैं. तो ये काफी स्टे करते हैं, दे क्वाइट गुड एंड अ बिग बॉक्स इज वेरी रीजनेबल फॉर 90. अदरवाइज एक्रेलिक पेंट्स कैन बी क्वाइट एक्सपेंसिव. सो ये है सिर्फ दो कलर्स और ब्लैक के साथ एक इमेज, वेरी पावरफुल इमेज ऑफ अ देवी पेंटिंग. आई हैव मेड इट ऑन अ स्क्वायर. आप रेक्टेंगुलर पे बनाए, बड़े पैनल पे बनाए. ये उसकी आईज की शेडिंग है, ये उसका 3D लुक है. ये नथ ऑलमोस्ट ड्राई हो गया है. अब ये माउथ है, दिस इज इट. सो इसमें अब अगर आपने और कुछ ऐड करना हो तो यहाँ पे आप अपने पतले ब्रश से आई लैशेज लाइनर मैं आपको दिखा सकती हूँ. थोड़ा सा ब्लैक लेके यू कैन डू योर लाइनर लाइक दिस. ये लोअर आई है, ये अपर आई है. सो द लाइनर वुड बी हियर. स्टेडी हैंड. आई थिंक आई लाइनर तो अब सबका हाथ स्टेडी है. सो इसमें भी पेंटिंग इज लाइक दैट. जितना प्रैक्टिस करोगे उतना आपका हाथ स्टेडी होगा.
So Malvika, how do you sketch, with the pencil or with the paintbrush initially?
No, I always sketch with a pencil.
Okay.
I sketch with a pencil and then when I have to outline, some paintings I cannot outline with black because I'm doing a light painting sometimes. So in that case, I outline with chalk. Jo white chalk nahi aata, jo white chalk. चौक होता है जो क्लासरूम में यूज करते हैं, आप उससे भी आउटलाइन कर सकते हैं. पर अपनी स्केच पेंसिल से बनाइए क्योंकि पेंसिल्स की जो लेड होती है ना उसे हाथ बहुत इजीली फ्लो करता है. सो इट्स वेरी आई एम ओल्ड स्कूल. थोड़ा अपनी पेंसिल का प्रेशर कैनवस पे लो रखिए क्योंकि अगर आपका प्रेशर ज्यादा होगा तो जब आप उसको बाद में इरेज करना चाहेंगे तो वो डेंट छोड़ देता है कैनवस में. सो आई एम ट्राइंग टू नाउ क्रिएट अ लिटिल क्रीज. ये आंख की थोड़ी सी मैं क्रीज बना रही हूँ इधर.
पीपल आर आस्किंग कैन यू रिपीट द नंबर ऑफ द ब्रशेस यू
यूज्ड. वेल यू कैन यूज व्हाट ब्रशेस यू वांट. आई ये ब्रश नंबर 2 है, इट्स नंबर 2. आई एम यूजिंग अ ब्रश नंबर, this is a brush number 8. This is a brush number 12. I have only used 3 brushes. Very little knife work I've done with this.
Neeru, आप अपने आप को unmute करिए. आपको question पूछना है ना, Neeru?
जी, हाँ जी.
हाँ.
Yes. मालविका जी.
हाँ जी, हाँ जी. नमस्कार.
मेरे पास acrylic में orange color नहीं था, तो मैंने इसको base pink करा.
That's perfect. मैंने तो आपको कहा था कि आपको जो पसंद हो या जो अवेलेबल है आप उससे ही कीजिए.
तो मैं अब इसमें आईज में मैं कैसे, मतलब अब क्या करूं, इसको थोड़ा डार्क करूं, कैसे करूं आईज में और लिप्स पे? तो मैंने क्या करा, फेविक्रिल का मैंने ऑरेंज कलर बना के फेविक्रिल का कर दिया.
आप थोड़ा सा अपनी पेंटिंग ऊपर करेंगे प्लीज. हाँ, इट्स लुकिंग नाइस, बट मैंने टोन ऑन टोन करना था. सो अगर आपको टोन ऑन टोन करना है तो पिंक में ही, पिंक कलर में, जैसे मैंने आपको दिखाया था कि लिप्स में भी डोंट यूज कलर्स डायरेक्टली, तो पिंक में अगर आप थोड़ा सा रेड ऐड करेंगे तो वो डार्कर पिंक हो जाएगा. ब्लैक मत ऐड करना बिकॉज ब्लैक
नहीं, 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 नहीं,
रेड में व्हाइट यूज कर लूं. नहीं, तो पिंक कलर आपने बेस पे यूज किया?
मैंने बनाया पिंक, इस पे रेड में व्हाइट मिला के मैंने पिंक बनाया, मेरे पास ट्यूब कलर थे एक्रेलिक के।
अच्छा, तो फिर आप उसको बस आप फिर से बनाइए, पर उसमें सफेद की मात्रा कम कीजिए और लाल की मात्रा बढ़ाइए।
आईज में और बिंदी में वो कर दूं?
हाँ, कर दीजिए, कर दीजिए। पिंक पे रेड बिंदी भी बहुत अच्छी लगती है। सुमित, आई एम बेस्ड इन साउथ दिल्ली and I run my classes online because of the pandemic. मेरी classes online है सबके लिए, और ये myth है कि online आप art नहीं सीख सकते, आप बहुत अच्छी तरह सीख सकते हो। आज तो बहुत ही general class थी because time कम था, थोड़ा introduction था ताकि आप सब उस festive mood में चले जाएं, we all need some positivity. बट आप पर्सनल क्लासेस लीजिए, मेरी ग्रुप क्लासेस भी होती हैं, तो प्लीज मुझे मैसेज कीजिए। आई कैन शेयर माय नंबर हियर, तो आप मैसेज कीजिए मुझे एंड यू कैन कांटेक्ट मी फॉर क्लासेस। माय सपना, शुड आई गिव माय नंबर?
यस प्लीज, आई गेस प्लीज। एंड डू यू वांट टू शेयर द व्हाट यू चार्ज आल्सो, बिकॉज़ दैट माइट रियली मोटिवेट पीपल। If you want to
and
share.
Secondly, Malvika, there's another question. Will we do the eyeballs in this?
That is your choice. I'm not making eyeballs in mine, but you can make eyeballs. Let me just for a second take you back onto the painting and show you where you could make eyeballs. If you would make eyeballs in this, you would make take the center of the eye, yahan pe. And you could make half se bhi kam thoda sa eyeball yahan pe you can make if you'd like to make an eyeball. I'm going to leave it as it is. And then I also told you that you can make eyelashes if you want. I'm going to keep it simple. I quite like my baby being a little uncluttered.
If I were to make the eyeballs, then would I make them a black eyeball or would I have to use a lighter color?
I think if you're making the painting, जैसे मैंने बनाई है painting, तो फिर तो black eyeball better लगेगा, because सारी outlining black है. Single color paintings में बहुत impact होता है जब आप कम colors use करते हैं. I will just show you this painting that I have just finished. It took me 4 months. It's a 4 feet high painting. अब आप देखेंगे इसमें there is white, black, रॉयल ब्लू एंड देन देयर इज अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ अ लाइटर ब्लू, दैट्स इट. तो उसमें इम्पैक्ट बहुत आता है कम कलर्स में.
या ओके, आई हैव डन द आउटलाइनिंग, सो आई जस्ट पुट ऑन द कैमरा टू शो एंड देन आई विल डंक इट इन वाटर. इज इट ओके?
आई एम ट्राइंग टू, या इट्स ब्यूटीफुल, यू हैव डन अ ग्रेट जॉब एंड आई लव द शेप ऑफ योर बिंदी.
So nice. Then I dunk it in water and then afterwards...
You will dunk it in water after you wait, ma'am, for the paint to dry fully.
Yes. Yeah, for about an hour and then do it.
An hour or two if you're busy. The busier the better, because you don't want to make the mistake I made right now, because I was in a hurry to see. My phone number is 98100 15723.
Could you please repeat it once?
98.
You can write down in the chat box.
I'll write
98 100 15723.
Yeah. So coming back to I think I'll send it to everyone. I made a mistake. One second.
I did. Don't worry. I did.
Neetu, people want to see what you have done. Can you?
Neetu, please show your painting.
I've just done the outline.
So what? Let's see.
Yeah. But it's beautiful.
It's come out nice.
आप लोग सब gallery view करके देख सकते हैं, और let me spotlight it. One second, Neetu, keep holding it, please.
Yeah, we can see it now.
Yeah, Neeru ma'am, your painting has also come out beautiful. And aapki painting mein mujhe
thank you. Thank you.
Bahut pasand aa rahe hain.
Thank you.
बिकॉज आपके डार्क पिंक बिंदी है डार्क पिंक आईज के साथ जो ऑरेंज लिप्स आए हैं वो बहुत अच्छे लग रहे हैं. The orange lips are looking very nice. I would not change that. I would keep them all.
Lips रहने तो ऐसे ही?
ऐसे ही बहुत बढ़िया लग रहे हैं. They're looking very nice. Pink and orange is in any case, it's trending for the last few years, so it's very nice.
Nuts में क्या color करूँ?
Nuts तो आपकी gold होगी. Nuts तो gold होगी. So Sapna was suggested that I share the prices with you. I had conducted a group online class for just ₹999. It was for 2.5 hours, and I taught people how to make roses on canvas. But personal classes are for ₹600 per hour online. So you typically can take a set of a few classes together, and it works. And there's a lot of interaction. उसके बाद WhatsApp पे आप कितनी बारी आप अपने doubts पूछ सकते हैं या we are connected, so it's great. And I also do art therapy online. So if any of you or people who you know are suffering from some ailment, it is very very effective. So that's a great module. क्योंकि painting एक वही जरिया है जिसमें हमारा mind hold back नहीं करता. क्योंकि आप psychiatrist के साथ भी होंगे तो आप सोच के बात करेंगे. पेंटिंग के टाइम आप सोचते नहीं है. दैट इज वेयर द हीलिंग हैपेंस. सो डू रिमेम्बर व्हेन यू फिनिश योर पेंटिंग्स, इट वुड बी ग्रेट इफ आई कुड गेट इमेजेस ऑफ योर फिनिश्ड पेंटिंग्स. दैट वुड बी लवली. आई कैन पोस्ट देम इन माय इंस्टाग्राम स्टोरीज. आई एम श्योर दे हैव शेयर्ड माय इंस्टाग्राम एंड फेसबुक लिंक्स हियर. माय ईमेल आईडी इज आल्सो शेयर्ड हियर. सो गेट इन टच विद मी. एंड
अलविका, डू यू वांट टू रिक्वेस्ट द पीपल हु हैव डन एक साथ आ जाए. I'll do it a gallery. जिन्होंने भी आज करा है,
I'd love that. I'd love a screenshot of that. Can everyone please pick up their paintings and
has done it? And
yeah, just hold them for Sapna. So I'm gonna count 1, 2, 3. Everyone up. Sapna, you've got
1 second. 1 second. Payal, ठीक से रखो सीधी. We can't see it. Payal, सीधी.
One, two.
One second, Malvika. I can see all the picture. Payal, आपकी पेंटिंग टेढ़ी है. ऐसे सीधी कर लो, ऐसे सीधा. स्क्रीन की तरफ पायल. हाँ, और ऊंचा. All right, good, great. Now 1, 2, and 3. And Vandana, you can smile because you're being visible. Neeru, please hold करिए. Okay, now 1, 2, and 3. Great. I got
this. So do remember, आप याद कीजिए कि आपने पेंटिंग से पहले क्या मन्नत मांगी थी, एंड मेक श्योर दैट आप यू एम्पावर दैट थॉट एवरी डे विद योर पेंटिंग. प्लीज सेंड इमेजेस एंड विश यू ऑल लॉट्स ऑफ गुड टाइम्स. सबके लिए सबको अच्छी सेहत मिले. मे यू ऑल प्रॉस्पर विद द देवीज ब्लेसिंग्स. टेक केयर एंड have a fabulous festive months now.
Malvika, people are asking for more painting therapy, so I think we can have another session on just on painting therapy.
Of course, I'd love to do that. Art therapy is it works like nothing else.
Your smile is working right now. You have a beautiful smile and it's really working on people.
Thank you so much. But I honestly, I'm at my age, I also feel that sometimes 1 hour of art therapy has more benefit than even going to the psychiatrist. Because art therapy aapke subconscious mind mein jaati hai aur baaki cheeze nahi jaati. So agar aap natural cheezon se apne aap ko heal kar sakte hain, why not?
Thank you.
Sandra, you want to wind up?
Yeah. So with that note and sabki request ke liye, we'll request Malvika to come back on Devdithi stage to give some pain therapy. And
my honor, always.
Thank you, Malvika. And thank you all of you jinhone participate kiya, painting kari. It's such a, you know, jo teacher hota usko bahut achha lagta hai, jo agar bachche saath mein karte hain students. So it was nice having you, Malvika, today. And
lovely. My pleasure, ma'am.
थैंक यू. और देवीदी फाउंडेशन की तरफ से सपना वंदना वी आर को फाउंडर हम दोनों की तरफ से थैंक यू सो मच. वी ऑल आर ब्लेस्ड टू हैव पीपल लाइक यू टू गिव अस टू शेयर योर नॉलेज विद ऑल ऑफ अस. एंड ऑन वेंसडे वी हैव अनदर सेशन कमिंग अप ऑन द knowledge about our condiments and dry fruits. How can we use them as therapy at home with our own Devditi Deepa Kapoor. So see you all on Wednesday. And with that, thank you. And thank you so much. All of you, good to see you.
Thank you, Vandana. And thank you.
Thank you, Nitri.